the director of the National School Nutrition Program, is now investigating reports that rotten food was given to children at the Eziphembeleni school in KZN. We're joined, in fact, by the KZN Education MEC, Kwazi Mshengu. Now, MEC, good afternoon to you. What was wrong with this food? What happened to it?
Afternoon, Stephen, and to your listeners. Well, we also got shocked about the video that is circulating, purporting that there is food that is given to children at Pambeleni High School, which is actually rotten stuff, as it is alleged. We then immediately dispatched the officials at a district level to go and investigate. And currently, the preliminary report that we got from the district official who went there, the principal and the service provider, is that actually that is an old video, which was not even taken at a school, but the principal is saying that it is being circulated by one of the educators who got expelled for misconduct at that particular school. But we have since said that the director for NSNP from head office must go there today and tomorrow and ensure that really what is in the school is fit for purpose, is food that is edible for learners, not expired food as it is alleged in the video. So that is currently what the information that we have, Stephen, so far. But we are not just letting the matter go away based on this preliminary report. We will, based on what the head office is finding out tomorrow, also make some pronouncement if there is a change of information in regard to this matter.
Okay, so at this stage, MEC, you haven't had a report that any children have actually fallen ill?
No, there is no report of such, either from the parents or the learners themselves or even the school. As I'm saying, that the principal is confirming that everything that was delivered is fit for purpose. It's food that is ready to be eaten by the learners. He's alleging, as I said, that that video is an old video that is being circulated for malicious reasons. But the district director will give us the final report. But having said that, Stephen, I do want to indicate that as a department, we have taken a very serious stance against anyone who wants to abuse doing business with us. We have had, for example, instances where some of the service providers are supplying insufficient quantities of product in our schools. Others are failing even to supply completely. And in those instances, we have acted decisively to terminate all those service providers. And if this one, indeed, it is found that someone supplied the food that has expired, we'll not hesitate to terminate, but we'll also seek better ways to ensure that that particular service provider is blacklisted, because we cannot allow a situation where people take advantage of what government does for the benefit of our learners.
Around the country, it's at least 9 million children who actually rely on the school nutrition program. And you're the expert on your province, obviously, but I'd imagine you're looking at least over 1 million children, maybe 2 million children in KwaZulu-Natal who rely on the program there. What kind of checks do you have in place to make sure the food that they get is actually the food they're supposed to have and is properly nutritious?
Well, we have a number of systems that are in place, including properly trained food handlers as well as food inspectors, that each and every school has what we call the senior food handler, who must ensure that every time food is delivered, it is of required quantities, it is of required standard, it is actually what is being ordered by that particular school. And we then have district-based food assessors who then go around different schools for spot checks to ensure that everything that is delivered is according to the specification. So really our systems are tight. Even those ladies who are cooking have also been trained to ensure that before they cook, they need to inspect food so that they don't find later on that they cook something that has expired or will then endanger the health of our educators, learners as it were. That is why we have really not had instances in the province where learners get sick because of the food that they get given at school. The only challenge that we have had are service providers that are failing to honor our agreements, either by failing to deliver at all or delivering insufficient quantities. And as I said, we have acted decisively against those service providers.
MEC, I really appreciate your time on The Pulse. Thank you very much indeed. Kwazi Mshengu, the MEC for Education in KwaZulu-Natal.